no time, I got too much on my mind. Counting stacks, I'm just counting all these racks, yeah.
Son, that rep ain't gonna do shit but count somebody out, which means you got to knock that cracker on his ass.
Yeah. Cheap bitch.
And you got one round. Knock the fucker on his ass.
Got you. Got you, pops.
Knock the fucker on his ass.
Congratulations on your victory, boy. You look real good out there.
Oh, hell nah. Oh, hell nah.
We're really fucking impressed.
Oh, fuck. Damn, nigga. Oh, shit.
Welcome to the real world, baby.
Oh, shit.
Nutty night, bitch.
Let me fight. Damn.
I don't want to die in prison.
You're not gonna let me fight?
Easy, easy now, son.
Man, they fucked me up.
I'm trying to talk. Just take it easy now.
They fucked me up.
You're lucky to let you breathing.
I wasn't always this lucky.
This Kimbrin is no amateur. He could have turned pro years ago. He's been the amateur champ for 9 years. 9 years, are you gonna let him make it 10? That's right, that's why we're here, to get the gold medal. Now go get him, kid!
What's that, bro, you? Oh, fuck, okay.
All right. So we start round number one of Andre Bishop against the sensational Cuban Joel Savone. You know, I heard a lot of experts ringside talking about the lack of experience for Bishop compared to Savone. Of course, Savone's a 9-time champion, and you have to wonder and ask yourself, will the nerves of Andre Bishop start to get to him? Will he be rattled against such a worthy opponent?
Oh, he's fucked. Hold on. Oh, shit.
Halfway through this round. Teddy, typically in a fight like this, when we have a power puncher against a real high stamina, well-conditioned fighter, what adjustments do you usually see made throughout the fight?
Well, one of the adjustments is on the side of the power puncher. He may find out that he better stop looking for home runs, stop swinging for the fences. He may have to adjust his game ways using a jab ball, looking for singles and doubles, not just that big one over the fence.
Joel Savone's giving his opponent headaches here now. He's throwing punches, but he's able to block them away.
What tagging is that? What are you talking about? Come on, pussy. Oh, my God.
Able to dismiss that body shot. And now he's acting like a fighter.
What's up?
Coming back with the right hand after getting scored upon.
What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up?
Unbelievable pace here tonight. Both guys have no plans of having this fight go far. I'm sure the frame of reference for most is Hagler Hearns.
Yeah, you wonder if it's going to live up to that. So far, so good.
Really solid left hand by Andre Bishop. That's exactly what his corner wants him to do. Final 10 seconds of round number one. Good looking right hand after he got hit. The other day when we were talking to Andre Bishop, he said to have success in this fight, I have to land combinations. He landed a good one there.
That did pretty good. Let's go.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Joel Savone's putting forth a great combination there.
Hell no.
Well, the 9-time gold medalist Joel Savone has not been in a position like this often. Andre Bishop has built up a big lead.
I'm probably puffing the shit out of him. I'm not even looking at my hands on this. Oh.
That was nice. He just drew the punch from his opponent and then a good counter by Andre Bishop.
Whoa. Yeah, like running through the rain without getting wet. Beautiful.
Bishop's combination punching is just perfect there. Three punches landing. A little head hunting never hurt. Does it with the hook. Nice work, the left hand to the head. Savone's failure to protect himself from that left hand, it's become a big story now.
Yeah, and he has to understand why. He's not controlling distance. He's standing too close in front. Needs to adjust a little further out.
Targeting each other, the exchange was something special. Joel Savone's right hand scores well that time.
Chill out, for you get fucked up.
And now he's targeting upstairs.
Chill out, for you get fucked up.
He scores with the jab there.
You know, Joe, a lot of times you think about a jab being used by an outside guy, but to get inside, you need a cover. And there, right there, was the cover.
Joel Savone's the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Well-placed left hand there. Able to land with the right. Bishop's putting forth a little boom, boom, boom. A three-punch combination score. That's gotta hurt. Andre Bishop rocked by that power punch.
No.
Bishop is down. It seems to me that Bishop is right now uncomfortable with the pace that's being set in this fight.
Well, he started the pace. See, that's the funny thing about it. He set it, but he might not be able to keep it up.
I really like what Andre Bishop is doing here. He's scoring well against the veteran Savone. That is a strong uppercut there. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Left to the body. Trying to time that straight left hand, and he does so with ease. Coming to the halfway point of this third round, Savone's impressing the judges and himself with that right hand. Good combination punching out of him here.
Yeah, exactly. It's kind of like a musical, except right now, I don't think his opponent likes the tone of it.
And he returns on that exchange. Bishop's doing well here with that two-punch combination. Joel Savone's right hand did a nice job that time. That worked well for him. Exchange there. Very accurate with the overhand right.
Holy fuck. He's tagging the fuck out of him.
Oh, 10 seconds to go in the third round. Bishop's so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing.
Nigga.
Well, Bishop can string together a few rounds like that. This is going to be a very easy fight.
Well,
he looks like a confident fighter. All that amateur background is really showing.
Bishop's combination punching is working well here. Joel Savone was a substantial favorite here against the young upstart Andre Bishop. But Bishop is in control and headed to victory. And for the second time tonight,
oh my God,
he goes down.
Stand up.
What the fuck?
Andre Bishop's back up on his feet. What will he look like in the next few moments of this fight? That's the big question. Good left hand by Andre Bishop. Savone's putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. All right, here we go. Last 60 seconds of the fight. Joel Savone's defense is now serving him well. Nice job blocking that punch. Solid left hand. Scoring well with that hook by Andre Bishop. Nice strike after catching one by Andre Bishop.
Come on. You know I won. Let's go.
Savone's got a bloody nose right now. I don't know if it's broken, but the bottom line is it's going to be a distraction.
Keep moving. Gotta see this coming.
Really good work right there, landing the two punches in sequence by Andre Bishop. 10 seconds to go in this, the final round. Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. Teddy, who would have ever thought it? Two guys like this, brawlers, punchers, that it would go to a decision.
Well, his nose is bleeding,
exactly.
Not mine.
I mean, you thought you were going to get a firework display.
How come
he's
that never dropped?
Wind up getting a little bit of painting. Yet?
Knocked me down three times, but I still won. What the fuck?
Andre, how does it feel to be named Fighter of the Games?
It's terrific, honestly. Being voted Fighter of
the
Games,
baby!
It's an honor.
Gold medal, baby! Yeah!
This is my baby brother, my big baby brother, Rain.
Hey, big baby Bishop, I'm a fighter too, and one day I'm gonna be right where he is.
Disappointed. I'm the heavyweight gold medalist. No one went the distance with me. Nobody here could ever go the distance with me. I am the best fighter at these games.
Here you go.
Andre Bishop is a talented middleweight, but I think Isaac makes a good point. Regardless, both these young men could have very bright futures in professional boxing.
Oh, the weak-ass punch that nigga did on that bag. So, like, when somebody drop ice cream, that's what his punch is on, like.
All right, let's go. Way to go!
Oh, I didn't. That. All right. Fuck y'all. Oh, damn, nigga. Shit. I failed twice. All right, I got it the third time. Third time charm, I swear. Third time's the charm. Other two times, I was just playing around, you know what I'm saying? I was just showing y'all that you can lose sometimes. I was just, you know, trying to show y'all. But third time, shit, told you. Okay. Shit, I'm nice.
Beautiful, kid. You got your father's power.
He certainly does. His father hit like a heavyweight, too.
Shut up, I piss on you.
Gus.
You ain't your son.
Despite our differences, I've always said you're one of the best trainers in the business.
I don't care what you say about me, Queen.
Always nice to see you, Megan.
Always nice to see you too, Gus.
I'm bringing my daughter into the business. You know how good she is with fighters. I want her to manage Andre. You're a great trainer. Why not concentrate on what you do best and let Megan and I concentrate on Andre's career?
Thanks, but I think I can handle it.
Isaac Frost will be fighting for a title within 2 years. I can do that for you, too.
Thanks, but I can handle it.
Did this old man ever get your father a title shot?
He was on his way!
The only way to the title is through me.
Not if nobody can beat me.
Oh, you think so? You don't know who you're fucking with.
Dad.
You've been listening to this stupid old man.
Dad.
You don't know who you're fucking with.
I apologize.
Now, you have no reason to apologize. But your father, on the other hand, he chews fighters up and he spits them out.
Gus, if we just...
Megan, you're a good egg. But no way are we getting in bed with D.L. McQueen.
I respect your decision.
Signed with Teddy Atlas. We have a big night of boxing ahead. Plus, so many are looking forward to our undercard. It is the pro debut for the much-heralded Andre Bishop. The middleweight will be facing the crafty veteran Lucius Palmer. All from here, the Aragon Ballroom in Chicago right now. Palmer's pre-fight talk included a lot of discussion about the need to utilize the jab. Why so?
Well, first of all, he's a good fundamental fighter, and he's not a real physical fighter. So he understands where he has to be good. He knows he doesn't have, you know, great physical skills where he could just knock a house over. He knows he has to be good in this area, using that lead hand, the jab.
That's a good job by Bishop offensively. Landing his combinations is a key to victory tonight. Well, Teddy, here in this matchup, two guys who tend to go the distance. What do we look for early?
You know, I'm looking to see who can be more consistent in just one area. Who uses their jab a little bit steadier?
Good two-punch combo by Andre Bishop. Blocks that punch.
It's all right. Keep moving.
Combo lands upstairs. Carries that punch intended for the head. Overhand right can be so effective. Oh, a big shot comes home.
Fuck out of here.
Oh, right off the bat, he goes.
Don't put your hands on me.
Came out a little careless, and he paid a price.
Nigga. One more time. Don't put your hands on me. Pussy.
One, two, three.
Oh, he getting up.
Bomber's back up on his feet. Let's see what he has now.
Oh, shit, nigga.
And here we go again as Lucius Palmer tries to steal this round against Andre Bishop. A solid 1-2 combo, left-right by Palmer. That was an interesting first round for Andre Bishop, the American making his pro debut here. Teddy, Lucius Palmer's the kind of guy that could give a young up-and-comer like Bishop some issues.
He likes to steal the end parts of a round, kind of like Ray Leonard did against Marvin Hagler. Has to be careful for that.
Well, his opponent is opening up and coming forward, so I would think there are some opportunities that exist.
Yeah, I think some counterpunching opportunities. Opportunities not on the front end, but on the back end.
He's committed to that left hand, and it's working out. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Palmer. This is not a good sign for Andre Bishop. It appears that he's slowing at this point.
Yeah, what he needs to do is start placing his shots a little bit. But right now, as you just alluded to, he's just not throwing.
Halfway through this round here. Takes one, but gives one. Good work by Andre Bishop. Not much action as he just ties up.
Oh, I'm his headbutt again.
Bishop's coming through now beautifully. That's the combination punching he wants to put forth. I think Bishop scored really well there. He just damaged his opponent with that power shot upstairs. They both decide to bring it. Excellent hook to the head by Andre Bishop. Bishop's left now getting, working his way. Big shot. He goes down in the later stages of this round. He's going to try to survive it.
Hold a left hook with that. Bitch. I'm trying to get his ass again.
One, two, three.
He's going to get fucked up. Why are you doing a maneuver on the ring and shit?
A knockout victory to start your career, as if the buzz isn't big enough for Andre Bishop. This will put fuel on that fire. He gets rid of Lucius Palmer. Impressive stuff.
You can't. I'm just too goddamn good.
Back here in the Friday Night Fight Studios, I'm Brian Kenny. Amateur gold medalist Andre Bishop taking his first steps as a pro this past weekend on the undercard at the Aragon Ballroom in Chicago. Bishop beating former welterweight contender Lucius Palmer en route to his first pro win. Now, we've seen Palmer before here on ESPN. He's a veteran. He's no joke. And Bishop is now considered to be one of the best prospects boxing has seen in decades. By beating a fighter the caliber of Palmer in his pro debut, no less, he definitely made a statement. Andre Bishop clearly a fighter to watch. In other news, heavyweight prospect Isaac Frost scoring the second knockout of his pro career, beating another overmatched opponent on the undercard of a McQueen pay-per-view in Las Vegas. He's now 2-0 with two KOs. After I hit metamorph, hey, I am a dog girl, a boy, hey, she pregnant wife in a bush, hey, that is expensive abortion, hey, I ran it up, fuck a portion, hey, ain't got no family like us.